Sorry, I thought you were a monster. But if you're not a monster, then who are you? And what are you doing here?
Adol gave his name and explained that he had come at Ricardo's behest.
Oh, so you're the guy Ricardo got, huh? I don't know where he found you, but you sure do look the part. Okay, thank you. You're a lifesaver, you know that? The mayor's still down in the tunnel, as far as I can say. The boss has been searching around the entrance, mainly, but I guess the mayor got himself stuck farther in. But the last time the boss checked in was a while ago. I sure hope the monsters haven't eaten those two. Don't give me chills just thinking about it. Anyway, I really appreciate you coming.
Come on.
might you be? And what in the world are you doing here? Can't say as I've ever seen you around before. You from Ballastine Castle? Adol introduced himself. I see. Well, I'm glad you're here. I'm Dewey, the head miner in this quarry. I came here to look for Mayor Edgar, but this is as far as I got. He's in serious danger here, though. I can't just leave him. Unfortunately, the monsters down there are in a class all their own. Sword attacks just bounce right off them. Unless we can find some way of dealing with them, I don't see how we can possibly get the mayor out safely. Maybe check the storehouse. We found some pretty interesting artifacts a while back, locked up tight, but I've got the key right here. Since you're not a miner, though, I'm guessing you have no idea where... It's on the other side of... There's a room with two doors at the... I hate to be so...
My name is Dulan, Shade of the Great Will. I would have you show me your abilities, red-haired swordsman. Spin! Slice!
Dance! Spoke.
Is that the best you have to offer? Still, you have an unmistakable spark in your eyes. We cannot afford interference at this crucial juncture. I must report this at once.
Thank you.
Who are you? What are you doing in a place like this?
Adol introduced himself.
An adventurer? Well, if you're looking for Mayor Edgar, here I am. Adol, was it? Thank you for coming all this way. I was accosted by monsters and managed to lose them here, but hurt my leg quite badly in the process. I was actually just about to hobble my way into the strange old ruins beyond here. They're quite peculiar. I peeked my head in early. Adol, I'm sorry to impose upon you even further, especially since we've only just met. But would you be willing to examine these ruins in my place? With my injured leg, I fear what might happen to me should any more monsters attack. But I know it's rude of me to ask, but...
What are you doing here?
You don't listen very well. I believe we handed down a royal edict to close the quarry, did we not? If you'd just done as you were told, you wouldn't have gotten hurt. So spare me the lecture. Just do as Lord Maguire asks.
You! I wondered what had become of you. I've never imagined. You aren't really working for Count Maguire, are you?
Oh, but I am. I'm a devoted knight in service of the great Lord Maguire. Therefore, I'll thank you to keep a respectful tone when you address me. Who goes there? You aren't from Redmont. What business have you here?
Adol gave his name and explained the circumstances of his arrival in Felghana.
A friend of Dobie's? I never thought he'd come back. Certainly not now. No matter. Lord Maguire's orders were explicit regarding the closure of the quarry. If you've come to lead this old man out of here, then I suggest you do so immediately.
Wait! What about Eleanor? Or do you even care that she's been worried sick about you? She doesn't even know if you're alive or dead.
I've grown weary of playing nursemaid. She's 17. She's old enough to cope without her big brother. You should tell her to forget about me. Hell, coming from you, she might even do it. But where are my manners? It would seem I've forgotten to introduce myself. I am Chester Stoddart, a high-ranking knight in service of Felghana's lord, His Grace, Count Maguire. Adol, is it? As an adventurer, I know you may be tempted, but I'd advise you not to get involved in politics. That is, of course, unless you are eager to die.
Maguire is the Lord of Felghana, though he's not native to this land. He's actually from Rom. From the moment he took power here, he levied exorbitantly high taxes and pressured us into forced labor. Then, a few days ago, he ordered us to shut down Tigre Quarry. Naturally, we refused, since he gave us absolutely no reason. To think that Chester would willingly serve a man like that. What could possibly be running through his head? He left his little sister behind, too, and she hasn't heard a word from him in months. Honestly, I have a hard time believing it. Even now, knowing what I know, I keep thinking it can't be true. And what am I supposed to do? Just tell Eleanor to try and forget about him? I couldn't possibly agree to that. I'd never be so callous.
No!
Eleanor? How long have you been listening?
I heard you made it home from the quarry, and that you were hurt. So I thought I'd stop by to check on you, and I overheard your whole conversation. I'm sorry!
Eleanor! It's good to know Chester's all right, at least. But that's little consolation right now. Ever since they were orphaned 12 years ago, those two have really watched out for one another. Up until about 3 years ago, they lived at my house, and I'd always put Chester in charge whenever I was away. I figured it would teach him to be a responsible young man. Though, honestly, I never did get the hang of raising him. Could I persuade you to look in on Eleanor for me? Right now, I think she might find it easier to open up to an impartial third party.